Hi, everybody. This is Lisa Haven, and I've got a really interesting topic for you guys today. And that is verified warnings from former U.S. presidents about the invisible government running the U.S. with quote unquote no allegiance to the people. Now, we're also going to get into a letter that I'm going to show you that George Washington wrote, and I don't believe it's his only one, but there's going to be the one that I show you. And he actually warned people about this invisible government, also known as the Illuminati. And I'm going to go straight to the Library of Congress to show it to you as well. So let's just go ahead and dive into all the warnings that we have. And the reason that I thought I would do this today is because of everything going on with Ebola. You have to remember that one of the agendas from this invisible government or the invisible elite, if you will, or hidden elite, I should say, secret elite versus invisible, is to depopulate the earth. And they want it down to only so many people, and that's according to the Georgia Guidestones, as many of you are already well aware of, and I did a post on a while back. But these are warnings from people in authority and in our country anyway, and we need to take them serious because they know what's going on. And as George Santana said, those who do not learn from history are doomed to repeat it. And I fear, with everything going on, that we are very near to repeating something that happened in other countries. Now, past presidents of the United States and other high-profile political leaders have repeatedly issued warnings over the last 214 years that the U.S. government is under the control of an invisible government owing no allegiance and acknowledging no responsibility to the people. According to six of our former presidents, one vice president, and a myriad of other high-profile political leaders, an invisible government that is incredibly evil in intent, notice that, had been in control of the U.S. government ever since the days of Andrew Jackson, that is, since 1836. They virtually run the United States government for their own selfish purposes, as we can see very evidently today. They practically control both parties, and we've said that for a while. They control both, Democrats and Republicans. It operates undercover of a self-created screen and seizes our executive offices, legislation bodies, schools, courts, newspapers, and every agency created for the public protection. As a result, we have come to be one of the worst ruled, one of the most completely controlled and dominated governments in the civilized world. No longer a government by free opinion, no longer a government by conviction and the vote of the majority, but a government by the opinion and the duress of small groups of dominant men. All right, so that's kind of what we're going to get in today, and then we're going to share some quotes from the people who are basically like the Rockefellers and the Ben Bernankes and those who are actually part of this Illuminati group or secret group that is running the government. Okay, so the warnings listed below, and he puts them in chronological order from starts with George Washington. Now, here's the actual quote. He quotes it, and he also quotes that it can be found at the Library of Congress. So let's go to the Library of Congress because I want to go straight to the source. Okay, so here we are, as you can see, memory.local.gov. If we go to new search, American Memory Library of Congress. Okay, so just want you to note that. That's where we're at. See this info. Let's go back, and that's when we do the search, but I've already done the search for us. The George Washington Papers at the Library of Congress, and this is what you want to look for. But here's what he wrote, and let's just read them directly. Right here, and you'll have to forgive the letter size. Revered sir, I have your favor on the 17th instant before me, and my only motive to trouble you with the receipt of this letter is to explain and correct a mistake which I perceive the hurry in which I am obligated often to write letters have led you into. Okay? It was not my intention to doubt that the doctrines of the Illuminati, that's what he wrote. The doctrines of the Illuminati and principles of Jacobeism had not spread in the United States. On the contrary, no one is more truly satisfied of this fact than I am. So what is he saying right there? He does not doubt that the doctrines of Illuminati and Jacobinism has spread in the U.S. In other words, he sees them spreading. Without a doubt, he knows this is what's going on. And so to say that the Illuminati doesn't exist, they existed in 1798. And they even came, you know, they came over from Europe. They're in Europe and they're here. Remember, Adam Weishaupt was over there, and he's the founder and starter of Illuminati, and that wasn't here in America. That was in Europe. And here we are today. Okay, but let's keep going. The idea that I meant to convey was that I did not believe that the lodges of Freemasons in this country had, as societies, endeavored to propagate the diabolical tenets of the first or pernicious principles of the latter. If they are susceptible to separation, that individuals of them may have done it, or that the founder or instrument employed to found the democratic societies in the U.S. may have had these objects and actually had a separation of the people from their government in view is too evident to be questioned. My occupations are such that but little leisure is allowed me to read newspapers or books of any kind. The reading of letters and preparation answers absorbed much of my time with respect. So there's his letter according to the Library of Congress. But this part here basically goes on to say that the democratic societies in the United States, basically influenced by things like the Freemasons and these secret societies, have tried to separate the people from their government. Basically, this is something that he's known. So obviously, we know he was a Freemason at some point, but whether he turned away from that, as some believe, which I believe he did, and this is an attempt to expose what's going on, but he reveals that it's already in the democratic societies in the U.S. So there you have it. Now here is the actual letter written by Washington, and this is attached at the Library of Congress so you can see it for yourself. All right, so there you have it. Kind of neat to look at, you know, some of our things from history. All right, so here are a couple of more quotes. This first one is from Thomas Jefferson, and he says this: I sincerely believe with you that banking establishments are more dangerous than standing armies. This is huge, and I want to show you the direct quote from the encyclopedia. All right, so here we are at the American President in the Encyclopedia Britannica. And here we are at our source document, Thomas Jefferson on Republican Government. Let's go all the way down to where he quotes it. Okay. I just don't want to like move it around. I want to show you guys. This is from the source. And I'm going to leave a link on all these quotes so you could check it. But right here: and I sincerely believe with you that the banking establishments are more dangerous than standing armies, and that the principle of spending money to be paid by prosperity under the name of funding is but swindling futurity on a large scale. So there we have it. There's our quote about the banking establishment. Okay, so let's go back to our next quote. And this one is by John C. Calhoun, Vice President from 1825 to 1832, and also a U.S. Senator. A power has risen up in the government greater than the people themselves. That's a problem. And consisting of many and various powerful interests combined in one mass and held together by the comprehensive power of the vast surplus in banks. Okay, these are 100% admission from people and in authority positions. All right, so let's just verify this quote real quick. Here's a wiki quote from John C. Calhoun, and let's go down to that section. There we are at the very top. A power has risen up in the government greater than the people themselves, consisting of many and various and powerful interests combined into one mass and held together by the cohesive power of the vast surplus in the banks. Okay, there's the proof of that quote. Let's go back. Now, one quick thing that I want you to note about this particular one about Washington and Jefferson's quotes above, or that I went through just a minute ago, regarding bankers and separation of the people from the government, this was realized back in 1836. Here we are in 2014. How much worse has it gotten? That's what we need to think about. If they were in there in 1836 attempting to separate the people from the government so they can have ultimate rule, what is going on now? Here's another one by Theodore Roosevelt. Behind the ostensible government sits enthroned an invisible government owing no allegiance and acknowledging no responsibility to the people. To destroy this invisible government, to befoul the unholy alliance between corrupt business and corrupt politics, is the first task of the statesmanship of the day. That's another huge quote. And this he wrote in an autobiography. So if you want to see the quote on that one, you got to go to read his book. All right, let's go on. One. Okay, this one is by Woodrow Wilson, and it says, a great industrial nation is controlled by its systems of credit. Our system of credit is privately concerned. The growth of a nation, therefore, and all our activities are in the hands of a few men. We have come to become one of the worst ruled, one of the most completely controlled and dominated governments in the civilized world. No longer a government by free opinion, no longer a government by conviction and the vote of the majority, but a government by the opinion of the duress of small groups of dominant men, aka Illuminati. And this quote was written in his book called The New Freedom in 1930. I will leave a hyperlink so you can go there and find the quote if you want to. All right, and here's another one from that same book, again from Woodrow Wilson. And since I entered politics, I have chiefly had men's views confided to me privately. Some of the biggest men in the U.S. in the field of commerce and manufacture are afraid of something. They know that there is a power somewhere so organized, so subtle, so watchful, so interlocked, so complete, so pervasive, that they had better not speak above their breath when they speak in condemnation of it. That's a scary thought, and people like me who speak against it, I'm sure, were targets. But let me just show you this book so you know it's linked. All right, this is on Gutenberg.org, and you can actually, you know, view the book here. The New Freedoms, a Call for Emancipation of the Generous Energies of a People by Woodrow Wilson, and this is it here. So you can go and find the information here. All right, just wanted to show that to you. Let's go back. Okay, so the next one is from New York City Mayor John F. Hyland in the New York Times in 1922. And instead of reading this, I'm just going to go to the source. Okay, so here we are on Wikipedia. Here's a picture to the right of John Francis Hyland. And let's go to his quote, which is straight up on here. Boom. All right, let me zoom this in. Okay, here it is. The real menace of our republic is the invisible government, which like a giant octopus sprawls its slimy legs over our city, states, and nation. To depart from mere generalizations, let me say that at the head of this octopus are Rockefeller, Standard, Oil interest and a small group of powerful banking houses generally referred to as international bankers. The little coterie of powerful international bankers virtually run the U.S. government and their own selfish purposes. Let's pause for a second. This is huge. He's one of the first, I guess, to point out the Rockefeller family as one of the ones. He gave names, okay, to some of this global cabal. But let's keep reading. They practically control both parties, both Democrat and Republican, if you will. They write political platforms, make caps, paws of party leaders, use the leading men of private organization, and resort to every device to place a nomination for high public office, only such candidates as will be amenable to the dictates of corrupt big business. In other words, they get politicians elected that they want elected, and they take politicians out that they want out. So anyone who comes against this global cabal or Illuminati gets ran out of town if they don't do what the Rockefellers and, you know, the global cabal tell them to do. And keep in mind, this was even in place before America, starting with Washington, the quote that I gave you earlier. They're already here and already infiltrating. These international bankers and Rockefeller Standard Oil interests control the majority of the newspapers and magazines in this country. Stop for a minute. This is huge. If they controlled the newspapers and magazines back in 1922, what do you think they control now? Huh? I am suggesting they control the media, especially the government-run media. This is why I like sources like BIN News, powered by the people. But this is a government-run thing controlled by the global cabal, and there's your proof of that. They use the columns of these papers to club into submission or to drive out of office public officials who refuse to do the bidding of the powerful corrupt cliques which compose the invisible government. It operates under the cover of self-created screen and seizes our executive officers, legislative bodies, schools, courts, newspapers, and every agency created for the public protection. That is huge. Let's go to another. Mr. Chairman, we have in this country one of the most corrupt institutions the world has ever known. I refer to the Federal Reserve Board and the Federal Reserve Banks. Amen to that. The Federal Reserve Board, a government board, has cheated the government of the U.S. and the people of the U.S. out of enough money to pay the national debt. Mr. Chairman, when the Federal Reserve Act was passed, the people of the U.S. did not perceive that a world system was being set up here. A world system, new world order, and that this country was to supply financial power to an international superstate, a superstate controlled by international bankers and international industrialists acting together to enslave the world for their own pleasure. This is from Congressman Louis T. McFadden in a speech delivered to the House, and I'm just going to show you it real quick. Here we are. And I'll link to this, as you can see, on a government area here. And here it is. We have in this country the most corrupt institutions in the world. There's your quote. All right, let's go back. Here's the quote from FDR. The real truth of the matter is, as you and I know, that the financial element in the large centers has owned the government ever since the days of Andrew Jackson. Okay, and I'll leave a link to that so you can check it out. But it's there. Let's go on to another one. Senator William Jenner in 1954 wrote this. Today, the path of total dictatorship, which I believe we're kind of there with Obama, in the U.S. can be laid by strictly legal means. We have a well-organized political action group in this country determined to destroy our Constitution and establish a one-party state. It operates secretly, silently, continuously to transform our government. This ruthless, power-seeking elite is a disease to our century. This group is answerable neither to the president, the Congress, nor the courts. Ooh, it is practically irremovable. All right, I'll also leave a link to his quote so you can check out his speech on that. And I do highly suggest that there's a lot of interesting stuff. That was not the only stuff that he said. Okay, so let's go on to J. Edgar Hoover. The individual is handicapped by coming face to face with a conspiracy so monstrous he cannot believe it exists, which they still don't today. The American mind simply has not come to the realization of the evil which has been introduced into our midst. It rejects even the assumption that human creatures could espouse a philosophy which must ultimately destroy all that is good and decent. Huge. Okay, this is on WikiQuote, and here is the quote right here. You want to pause it, you can check it and read it for yourself. but let's go on. Okay, here's probably one of the most famous ones by John F. Kennedy, our 35th president of the U.S., and he delivered this in a speech to the American Newspaper Publisher Association on April 27, 1961, and you can find it. I'll leave a link, the audio for that, but the very word secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society, and we are, as a people, inherently and historically opposed to secret societies, to secret oaths, and to secret proceedings. Our way of life is under attack. Those who make themselves our enemy are advancing around the globe. No war ever posed a greater threat to our secret security. If you are awaiting a finding of clear and present danger, then I can only say that the danger has never been more clear and its presence has never been more imminent. For we are opposed around the world by a monolithic and ruthless conspiracy that relies primarily on covert means for expanding its sphere of influence, on infiltration instead of invasion, on subversion, excuse me, instead of elections, on intimidation instead of free choice, on guerrillas by night instead of armies by day. It is a system which has conscripted vast human and material resources into the building of a tightly knit, highly efficient machine that combines military, diplomatic, intelligence, economic, scientific, and political operations. Its preparations are concealed, not published. Its mistakes are buried, not headlined. Its dissenters are silenced, not praised. No expenditure is questioned. No rumor is printed. No secret is revealed. That's huge. And that's coming from JFK, which I believe that is one of the reasons he was assassinated, because he was exposing these groups. Okay, here's another one from Congressman Larry P. McDonald, and this is from the introduction to a book titled The Rockefeller File. The Rockefellers and their allies have for at least 50 years been carefully following a plan to use their economic power to gain political control of first, America, and then the world. Do I mean conspiracy? Oh, yes, I do. I am convinced there is such a plot, international in scope, generations old in planning, and incredibly evil in intent. Huge. And I'll leave a link. And here's another one from Daniel K. I can't pronounce his last name, but he's a senator from Hawaii in 1986. There exists a shadowy government with its own air force, its own navy, its own fundraising mechanism, and the ability to pursue its own ideas of national interest, free from all checks and balances and free from the law itself. Do you see where we have came since Washington to now? Washington just said that they had invaded the country, okay, that they were there. But now, instead of invading, they have taken over. Okay, so here's a few more quotes from the Federal, about the Federal Reserve, which is probably one of the evilest organizations in my opinion, but from John C. Calhoun, a power has risen up in the government greater than the people themselves. This is talking about the Federal Reserve. Theodore Roosevelt, owing no allegiance and acknowledging no responsibility to the people. Louis McFadden, one of the most corrupt institutions that the world has ever known. I refer to the Federal Reserve Board and the Federal Reserve Bank. Here's the thing. There is a global cabal, a invisible group, the Illuminati. They're running our country, okay? And they're doing whatever the heck they want, putting in rules in place, regardless of we the people and what we the people are doing and standing up for. So we need to just be aware. And one of the worst organizations is the Federal Reserve. Now, here's what Jim said on PBS NewsHour on September 18, 2007, where he basically, I guess in an interview with Alan Greenspan, he said, what is the proper relationship? What should be the proper relationship between a chairman and the Fed and the president of the United States? Well, first of all, said Alan Greenspan, the Federal Reserve is an independent agency. And that means basically that there is no other agency of government which can overrule the actions we take. Whoa. So long as that is in place and there is no evidence that the administration or the Congress or anybody else is requesting that we do things other than what we think is appropriate things, then what the relationships are don't frankly matter. Huge. That is huge. Anyhow, I could read some more quotes from David Rockefeller and others in regards to some of the things that they are doing, but maybe I'll list some of those on the Before It's News post. If you want to check that out, let me go back to the top here. I highly, highly suggest it. But for now, this will conclude some of the warnings that we have heard from presidents on the invisible government. And I want you guys to wake up to this. People still try to say that there is no such thing. Yet we have Illuminati symbolism on our clothing. We have Illuminati symbolism on TVs and newspapers and everywhere that we go. We see this symbolism. This represents the global cabal that is running our country. And we need to be aware that they are there. And if people high up in government are warning us about it, obviously that warning has kind of long gone with Obama because he's just their puppet, along with Biden and everybody else. We need to wake up to the chaos. They are going to implement a new world order, just as they have been promoting, you know, forever. And we need to wake up.